Far away from Sacramento, and our family hardly get together like this all the time. But when it comes times like this, this is what you need. You always need your family. Amen. Okay, when I received a call that Marie's passed, I didn't know what to think. I don't know what to do. As I received the call, I was getting ready to go to church on a Sunday morning. You know, things like that, you know, it makes me feel like I don't know what to do. But thanks God, there's a living God.
Amen.
I sat down on my bed and I asked God what I'm going to do. Losing somebody that you love the most, or any member of your family, is really hard. If you don't have Christ in you. But if you have Christ in you, it's not hard. Because you know exactly where that member of your family is heading to. And life doesn't end here. So, my family and friends, let's put God first in our life. Everything we do, put God first. That's the Bible says, those who die in Christ, those are the first ones to be right when Jesus comes. And when you die without Christ, amen.
Amen.
But talking about Marie, we are here today to celebrate Marie's going home. Marie's not dead yet. She's sleeping. That's why I'm not crying. Because I know where Marie's heading to. And Marie is one of the niece that I have. I love the most. There was one time in my life I took care of her. I used to pick her up from school. I used to take her around with the dad and the mom, you know, at work or doing their things. I used to babysit her, me and my wife. And Marie is one of the person that I only tell her one time. I tell her, do something one time, Marie will do it. And she knows me. She knows how I am. I only talk one. The second time I will talk, I will throw my hand on her. So, Marie is going home. So, family, don't be sad. I know it's sad. No, we're not going to see her around, but she's in a better place than us.
Amen.
Amen. In the name of Jesus, amen.